Welcome back, friends. Today I have Phil barefoot and in the kitchen. What you making me?
Where I belong.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, when I'm making beef stew, it's where I belong because I love making beef stew. Some of my favorite things are the low and slow things that you kind of put the ingredients in and you smell it cooking all day. So it feels like you're working when you're actually just like watching TV and playing video games because you can smell it cooking in the oven. I love that.
That's like my whole thing with the beef stew is I sit on the couch and wait for it to be presented to me. I've never actually made it.
Well, I would like to keep it that way because I love making it. It's a lot of fun. You can kind of change it up every time. There I use olive oil, but I'm sure if you were doing it, it would probably have a little bit of butter in there.
I'm going to say yes, it would have a little bit of butter.
A lot of bit of butter. So here I'm putting in the beef into the pan. The key is not to crowd the pan out because then you'll steam it and you won't get the good crust that you're looking for on the outside where all the flavor is.
Now the one downside to beef stew is that it has to go in the oven for a very long time, so it's very difficult for me to get my crusty bread to go with this.
Yeah, I guess you actually can do it on the stovetop. The recipe that I'm doing here originated from one of my mom's recipes because I loved her beef stew and I wanted to learn how to make it for myself.
Yeah.
And she always did it on the stovetop.
Oh.
You just got to keep a closer eye on it and stir it to make sure that it doesn't burn on the bottom. And maybe I'm a little bit lazier than my mom, so I'm like, okay, I'll just put it in the oven 300 degrees and you don't have to worry about it for a few hours.
Having met your mom, you're a lot lazier than her.
That's true. I think
that woman is unstoppable.
That's definitely true. Here I'm putting in the second round of beef into the pan and just pulling it out once it's done. Doesn't have to be completely done because it's going to be cooking low and slow for a long time. But once that fond starts building up and if you smell it starting to be on the edge of burning, it's time to deglaze it. Here I'm using a dark sweet beer to just get all that good flavor off the bottom.
And here is also an exercise in patience. Look at how he just like doesn't crowd that pan, gets everything the nice brown it needs to be. I would have no patience. I'd throw it all in the pot and then guess what you get? Steamed meat.
Now that sounds yummy. You want a trough of steamed meat? So here is the last batch of the meat here. So the fond is gonna get scraped off the bottom and deglazed with everything else, but it can just stay in the pot.
Did we discuss the meat? What is that meat?
That is stew meat. So a lot of times you'll go to the grocery store, Sam's Club or Costco or one of those places. They'll have a big package of stew meat. It's really good cuts of meat usually, but sometimes it's a little bit more, how would you call it, a little tougher?
Yeah, I would say it's like your cheaper cuts that need some like slow loving.
Yeah. So there's a lot of flavor there, but it takes a long time to cook. So it's good for chilies, beef stews, that kind of stuff. And that's what I use this time. You can use a top round roast. You can use a bottom round roast. You just cut it into small pieces and same thing.
Yeah, this is like the one cheat is buying the stew meat where you're not actually breaking down a big, huge roast because I've seen you do that before too.
That's true. So here I'm getting in a little bit of flour to thicken it up, added the rest of the beer. And I got some dried spices here. If the garden was going, I'd get some of this from the garden. I'd go out to the paprika bush and just get the, just kidding. I would still use the paprika from the little jar because I think that's, what is paprika?
I think it's a pepper. I think it would have been a bush.
That's right. Maybe I will do a paprika bush.
I doubt it.
I doubt it too. And here I'm putting in a bunch of beef stock and then stirring everything up.
Now, let's have a conversation. What do you think about this low sodium beef stock that they have out there?
Okay. I have a strong opinion on that.
Oh, okay.
So the low sodium beef stock seems like a good idea when you're in the grocery store. You're like, yeah, this is good. I want less sodium. But it also has less flavor. So as you're tasting it, you end up adding more salt anyway. I don't know if it's the same.
That's a moot point.
It seems like a moot point to me. And then I just tested it a couple times. You want to make sure it's nice and tender, has the flavor you want. And then I just put it on the stovetop and start throwing in vegetables.
Yeah, he gets it to the perfect, it's like your fork can go through it super easy, but it doesn't disintegrate. You can take it to that disintegration point and that's not good. So it's kind of like a fine line. So just kind of keep on testing throughout the cook.
Yep, you'll know when you bite into it and you're like, yep, that's exactly how I want it. Maybe you do want it a little bit firmer. Just take it out when it tastes exactly what you want.
Mm-hmm. I find for these stews, those Yukons are like the best potato.
Yeah, you can use the red ones, but something about the Yukons, they get like really creamy and...
Yeah, creamy.
And they look good on camera.
Yep.
Because they're nice and golden.
I find those red bliss ones kind of disintegrate a little over time.
Yeah, they do. and I love to get a little bit of crunch. So this goes in toward the end. I'll put in the celery, and then I always put in a bunch of parsley. It gives really good color. It gives a nice fresh. So I'm gonna shut this off. I think you'll see me reach in there and shut it off. Yep, and then just put the parsley in right at the very end.
And you can always just go with the whole head. I don't think you can over parsley.
No, I really don't think you can either. And there it is.
Look at the colors in that. That is gorgeous. No editing there. That's how it looks.
Yep, ready for a nice crusty roll to soak up all that goodness.
Oh yeah.